Hello, and warming welcome to Dham Music YouTube channel. I'm so excited to have you here for part 2 of The Loyal Pin. If you haven't yet watched part 1, don't worry. Just click the icon that appears in the top right corner of this video, and you'll be redirected to it. Alternatively, you can visit my channel to find the summary of part 1. Before we dive into the story, please remember to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and feel free to drop any suggestions in the comments. Your support means a lot to me, and it helps me bring more content like this to you. Now, let's get started. The Loyal Pin Part 2. The Pine Palace is finally complete, marking a grand achievement after almost 6 years. Lady Pin, Kun Pin, has been eagerly counting down the days, awaiting the return of Princess Anil. The palace is as extravagant as one might expect, with a tennis court nestled beneath towering pine trees, a testament to Princess Anil's unique style and sophistication. As the palace comes to life, the Grand Prince finds himself caught in a whirlwind of emotions. He is preparing for his marriage to Lady Parvati, but his heart is conflicted due to his feelings for Lady Yuangfa. Meanwhile, Preek takes a tour of the Pine Palace, admiring the beautiful setting and complimenting Princess Anil on her exquisite taste. Later, during the preparations for the Grand Prince's engagement, something unexpected happens. Kun Pin notices someone approaching, and to her surprise, it's Princess Anilafat. After so many years, she has finally returned. As Princess Anil re-enters the scene, emotions run high. Lady Pin's heart races when Princess Anil gently touches her, sending a wave of confusion and excitement through her. Unable to fully grasp her feelings, Lady Pin searches for answers in Princess Anil's eyes. With a soft voice, she asks, "What do you mean, Princess?" Princess Anil gazes back at her, her expression calm yet intense. "With you. It's different," she replies, her voice filled with a gentle sincerity that suggests her feelings go beyond mere friendship. The words hang in the air, heavy with emotion. Princess Anil struggles to find the right words, and Lady Pin can feel the weight of what remains unspoken. Overwhelmed but exhilarated by this newfound revelation, Lady Pin's heart flutters. She had never imagined that Princess Anil could feel this way about her. Caught up in the moment, Lady Pin stammers, "I don't know what to say." Her voice barely carries above a whisper. Princess Anil smiles softly, tenderly brushing her thumb across Lady Pin's cheek, then whispers, "You don't have to." Their lips meet, and for Lady Pin, the world seems to fall away. It's a moment of joy, a deep realization of feelings she had buried long ago. As they pull apart, there is lock once more, this time with a shared understanding. In that fleeting moment, their bond transforms into something deeper, something more profound than mere friendship. Princess Anil's return brings more than just reunion. The complex relationship between her and Lady Pin continues to unfold in intimate moments. Princess Anil longs for Lady Pin in a way that is not easy to express. Lady Pin, always eager to please, tries her best to cater to Princess Anil's wishes. She prepares a Western breakfast, hoping to impress, but soon realizes that Princess Anil, after spending time in England, desires something different. Without missing a beat, Lady Pin adjusts and prepares the dish the princess truly craves. Meanwhile, Preek shares stories of people Lady Pin interacted with while Princess Anil was away. Although Princess Anil listens quietly, a subtle tension builds within her, hinting at her mixed emotions. Despite this, Lady Pin continues to serve Princess Anil throughout the day. Her efforts are testament to their unspoken connection and Lady Pin's internal battle with her feelings. The grandeur of Prince Anantawat's wedding is a spectacle to behold, putting the Sawatawarat family in the spotlight. The ceremony is magnificent, sparking conversation across the kingdom. Yet, despite the lavish event, all eyes seem to be on Princess Anilafat. Her beauty has reached new heights, captivating everyone in attendance. Lady Yuangfa, who is visiting from Chiang Mai, finds herself particularly struck by the princess's transformation. Intrigued, Lady Yuangfa decides to pay a visit to the Pine Palace. Princess Anna welcomes her warmly, brewing English tea herself for their meeting. During their conversation, Princess Anil shares her concerns for her father's health, while Lady Yuangfa reveals her plans to visit her own family soon. The atmosphere shifts slightly when Lady Pin arrives. While polite greetings are exchanged, a quiet tension lingers, suggesting there are deeper feelings at play. As the day progresses, Princess Anil tries to lift the mood by mentioning a tennis match scheduled for the next day. Lady Yuangfa, meanwhile, mentions her plans to visit Chinatown with Aunt Eliza. Soon after, Lady Pin steps out for a short while, and before she leaves, Lady Yuangfa expresses her concern for Princess Anil's well-being, showing a growing bond between the two. However, beneath the pleasantries, tensions continue to simmer. Later, Princess Anil presents Lady Pin with a delicate flower arrangement, a gesture that carries both affection and unspoken emotion. Their interaction is playful, yet it deepens the complicated connection between them. After the tennis match, Lady Pin feels unsettled by Princess Anilifat's behavior. Sensing something is off, Lady Parvati approaches Lady Pin, asking if she's all right. Lady Pin admits that she feels confused by Princess Anilifat's actions. Lady Parvati, ever insightful, reassures Lady Pin, saying, "Princess Anilifat can be mysterious, but she means no harm. She's just complicated." Feeling slightly better, Lady Pin thanks Lady Parvati for her kind words, knowing she has someone to confide in. As Princess Anil leads Lady Pin through a series of tender kisses, each one filled with meaning, Lady Pin feels herself slipping deeper into the moment. Despite her confusion, she is drawn to the princess's charm and irresistible allure. Their affection grows, culminating in a passionate French kiss, a kiss full of longing and desire. In that instant, the boundaries of their relationship blur, and they find themselves on the verge of something much more than friendship. Thank you so much for tuning in to part 2 of Loyal Pins. I hope you enjoyed this chapter as much as I did. Things are really starting to heat up between Kun Pin and Princess Anil, and there's still so much more to come. Be sure to stay tuned for part 3, where we'll explore how their relationship continues to evolve and the new twists and turns waiting for them at the Pine Palace. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you have any thoughts or suggestions. Until next time, take care, and I'll see you soon.